you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you all about my 2019 planner. This is my third year with this planner because this is definitely one product that I can absolutely recommend. The quality, the features, just everything about this company and these planners, I always want to share my thoughts with for you guys. So today's video is going to be doing just that. We're going to look at the details about this planner, the customization options that I chose, and then other things that I have done to this planner to make it just my go-to book. This literally has my entire life in it. This year I decided to do things a little bit different. I have this whole planner set up and I've been, of course, using it for the whole month of January and half of February now. And so as opposed to me showing you a brand new planner that has not been used or touched or really like played around with, this you can see a little bit more of how I use this and just how this works for my daily life. So if you go on Purple Trail's website, you are able to kind of pick out the size that you want your planner to be. I have always gotten the same exact size and type of planner. I always choose the hardcover 8.5 by 10 inch, or you can choose a 6 by 8 inch. As you can see, it is spiral bound. And like I said, this is the hardcover version, but you can also choose a synthetic cover or a laminate cover. And just to give it some durability, I always choose that hardcover. But I love this size. It gives me a lot of writing space. And like I said, with this combination of planner, I have had no issues with the quality of my choices here. Here is an up close view of this gorgeous cover. This is the Vibrant Watercolor Flowers. I can literally spend about an hour looking at all of Purple Trail's covers that they have. They have so many options to choose from, and I always just screenshot my favorites and then kind of do a process of elimination from there. The other thing I love when it comes to covers and this company is that you are able to take this cover, and if you didn't like the background for whatever reason, you can change the background color to a color that you prefer. And so while the company offers so many pre-made and pre-designed covers for you, you are also able to customize it to exactly your liking if you don't like the color combination that they chose. The other thing that I love about the covers is that you are able to customize it, and you can pretty much add whatever you want on there, and you can add wording wherever you want. Literally, the customization options that you get with this company are endless. I had a little cutting board by me, so I am using that to cover up my personal information because I do have it listed there. Heaven forbid I ever lose this. I would really hope that whoever were to find it would return it to me, and so I have my address and phone number there. But here's what you see as soon as you open that cover of this planner. I chose the mom planner, and that is another option that I have just always stuck with. The layout and just how everything flows together just works really good for me. And so as much as I wanted to give other layouts a try, I love sticking to what works. There are other planners that are available. You can choose from a daily planner, a weekly planner, or a monthly planner. There are also teacher and student planners, wedding planners, meal planners, content planners. You guys get it. There's just lots of possibilities. So pretty much there is a planner for everybody. Hopping to the next page, you get a list of all of the holidays for both the present year and the following year. This has come in handy so many times. And turning that page over, you have a 2019 calendar and a 2020 calendar. Both of these calendars are your year at a glance. And then after you flip that page, you dive right into the year. On the left-hand side here, you have a sheet of lined blank paper. You will quickly see what I do with my blank pages as we go throughout the year. You do have a cover page for each month, and it's like a thicker piece of cardstock. It's just a nice divider between the months. And then you also have this laminated tab which reads the month. Turning that page, you can see you have another blank spot, which again, I always get a lot of use out of those blank spaces, and you will see why as we move through the planner. But on the right side of the planner there, you can see you again have the month, the year, you have a space to write any birthdays that are coming up, any events, and then you also have a things to remember little section there. Normally, I don't get too much use out of this page, but again, like I said, it's really nice to have. All right, and then turning that page, you have your month at a glance, and you have some space to fill in things. So this is what I use for YouTube, for my husband's company, and for Instagram. I just write down all of the social media aspects right in here. So for me, these two pages are solely dedicated to work. Here are my weekly pages, and you will see me kind of changing things up. I love finding different ways to use this planner that work best for me. On the left-hand side of the left page, I was able to customize what I wanted that extra row to look like. So the top half has my call and go section. That is just where I need to go, any errands I need to run, or any places, companies, people that I need to call. I prefer having this list in just one area. I try to group all of my calls together so I can just get them all completed within a day. And same with the places that I have to go. And when I'm out, it's easy to just look at that and make sure that I don't forget to go somewhere. And then as you can see, I just put a little hashtag or number sign for the places I need to call. And then for the places that I need to go to, I just put a little arrow. And then that left-hand column bottom section, I have a little area for my bills, what bills need to get paid that week. And then I have a section for Aiden and Bella. Usually Aiden just takes up this area, what needs to go on for school, what he needs to bring, what I need to sign. And then I have a little section, this is new for me for this year. I have a top three. So these are the top three things that I want to or need to accomplish this week. But this is the area where I try to really focus on making sure these items get done. And then on the bottom there, I have a little notes section. So because it's not specific, I'm able to use this for a whole bunch of different things. Whatever I need to write down, be reminded of, just goes right in that little section. Okay, so here's what the weekly layout looks like without my writing that kind of takes over the entire two pages. Each of the 7 days is separated into their own 7 columns. And then the top half here, you have a morning, afternoon, and evening. So you can kind of plan your day right in here. And then you have 4 blank boxes to use however you want. I have tested out working like by hourly, so you are able to start your day at 8 a.m. On this second line here, and you can go all the way up to 8 p.m. if you like to do like an hourly schedule. Of course, you can also pick an hourly layout. I have used these columns for working out, for meal planning, then again for what I would like to do during the day, and I have used multiple planners before finding out about Purple Trail. And one thing that I can never quite get right was the amount of space that I had. I love writing things out. I like being really specific with my planners. And so flipping to the end of February, here are my blank sticker papers that I use constantly. I love having this, and I love having this space in this planner because I am able to just fit so much in here. So I create these Word documents on my computer, and then I just use the blank sticker paper. I will have a link for the sticker paper that I use. I found some really excellent blank sticker paper that you get in bulk and for a really fair, decent price. So I will have that link down in the description box below. But here you can see, this is what I like to do for each day of the week. And then on this sheet, I have my monthly things. So this side is a lot more seasonal. I also have family and friend birthdays on this side. So this just kind of keeps us on track for what we need to get done, both for the house and just like as a family. And then on this side is just more of my like weekly chores, my daily chores. So pretty much this is like a household daily chore thing. Instead of having to write all of that stuff down in the weekly layout, this just kind of groups it all together and gives me an overview of what I am planning to do for each day. So like I said, this is just some extra space that the company provides you to pretty much do whatever you want with. Like I said, having those blank sticker pages has really come in handy because you are able to furthermore create and customize this planner to work exactly how you need it to. You can do work schedules here, you can do meal planning for the entire month. There's just endless possibilities when you have both the space and those blank sticker sheets. One other thing that I love is that each month has a different color. I like things to be colorful and to change each month. I think it just gives each month a like fresh new theme. So just for an example, you have a green theme for August, a like mustard yellow theme for July, more of an orange color for June, red for May, a really pretty coral for the month of April, and then a really nice purplish color for the month of March. Of course, there are more months and more colors. All right, and then jumping to the end of the planner, here are some add-ons that you can add to the back of your planner. Again, there's a long list of different type of sections that you want to include, and you can include up to 4 additional sections. Those are extra charges, but I have always found them to be completely worth it just because, again, you get so much space. So this first section of mine is a notes section, and I believe you get 20 lined blank pages. So here you can see what I'm doing with my notes. Right now I have this first notes page left blank, but turning that page I have 2 Christmas gift lists, and as you can see they're blank, but when that time comes and rolls around like it does so quickly, I already have my little lists pre-printed, ready to go. So again, this is just using those blank sticker pages, and this is just a printable little list that I found online. I also like looking up free printables that I am able to print out on those blank pages as well. And then turning that page, I have my 2 Christmas card lists. I love having these included within my planner because I don't lose them. I know where they are, and then I'm also able to really easily, quickly revert back to my previous year gift lists and card lists just to make sure that I'm not forgetting anything, kind of track and see how much I spent on each person last year. Turning that page, I have 2 whole house deep cleaning checklists. Again, free printables that I found online. Try to follow 2 deep cleans every year, 1 for spring, 1 for fall, and it's just nice being able to cross this stuff off. And like I said, having this included in the planner and not just like blank pages floating around, getting lost, getting damaged. I just like having it included in here. Turning those 2 pages, I have some blank pages here that I'm able to write on if I really want to. Most likely I will find some more printouts and I will use these 2 pages for that purpose. And then turning that page, I have my personal bucket list. This is a Word document that I created using their like graph makers. I want to have like a no spending month. This is just a personal bucket list for myself, but I do want to kind of spend some time working on this very soon, hopefully. Except I have 2 more sections that I added. I have my important reminders, and then I have a free printable that I printed out on what I want to achieve in 2019. Both of these sections, as you can see, are left blank. 2 more sections that I need to really focus on and spend some time with. I did use this like little chart that I created on Word last year, and it came in handy a lot. So I definitely need to carve out some time to get that filled out. And then I have a family bucket list for each of the 4 seasons. Again, something I need to spend some time on. And then my 3-year plan. This is for both house, family, and my goals. I have a column for 2020, 2021, 2022. These are like the big plans for all 3 years. So we're looking to purchase a new family car that will fit its way in hopefully within the next 3 years. We're also hoping to add on to our home. That will probably happen more towards the end of the 3-year chart here, so possibly in 2022. And then I also have a section for my 2019 plan, and those are just smaller, easier to achieve goals that we might want to do, whether it be like go on a little family vacation. All right, turning that page, you can see my next 2 charts that I created. So I have a home updates and changes chart. I go by room, so I can get pretty specific in here. They're just the things that I want to change for each space of our home, each room, just things that are very achievable to get done this year. And then on the right hand side, I have another chart, home updates. This is just to keep track of our home updates, repairs, and services. This has been really nice with like warranty work. I'm also able to look back on each year and just see what we've changed or what we've spent our money on when it comes to home repairs, upgrades, or services. And then if something goes wrong, I have the company's name and then their contact information. Again, I love that it's all just grouped together and it's really easy to understand, to read, and to follow. And then following that page, I have 4 charts in total of our health visits. This is just a really easy way to keep track of our health, how often we're visiting the doctor, why we're visiting the doctor. And then on that last page here, I have my photo ideas. So whenever I come across like a really cute little photography picture on Instagram or Pinterest, I try to recreate that scene in my head and just write down the ideas that I have right here. My next section of this planner is this to-do list. And again, I kind of just use the space and the pages of these sections to my own liking. I customize them so much. So here is my 2019 painting plan. This could have gone in the section before, the notes section. I have my declutter list here. I just noticed that it says 2018, so messed up on the year, but I like creating this because it kind of gives me a guideline on what areas I want to focus on for each room and just what items need my attention when it comes to decluttering, sizing down, just kind of organizing a little bit better. So I have my whole big plan right here. And then here is what the to-do lists look like if they are not covered by sticker paper. So you have 4 different sections. They're bulleted, they're lined, and they're also like separated. So that's really nice. So as you can see, I have lots of these pages left blank. Which I'm sure as we go throughout the year will end up getting written on or covered with that sticker paper. Here you can see how you can use those 4 different sections. So right up here, I have like gift ideas that I can tell people Annabelle could use or that I could look at myself for Easter, Christmas, birthdays. I have just things that I would like to get both Bella on this side, Aiden on this side. I have events that I would like to go to or things that I would like to do outside of the home with the kids, events with just Aiden. And then I have Aiden's activities, what he likes to focus his attention on sports wise, just to make sure that I am keeping him active and keeping him enrolled in stuff throughout the year. And then I have a little section for date nights that I would like Matt and I to go on. The next section that I always get is a bills section. This is really nice because again, it just kind of divides my finances. And here is what the bill tracker or the bill section looks like within this add-on section. So you have a bill name, a due date, a money section, and then notes. I don't typically use this layout. I pretty much just add this on to my planner so that I have this divider right here. And just so that I have a section solely dedicated to finances and money. Next up, I have this fitness tracker. Anything that is fitness or health related goes right in this area. All right, so after those 4 sections, I have also added on this folder. This is a really thick, high quality little folder. I usually keep receipts in here, especially for things that I have to return, and just like little floating around papers. I try not to have too many papers outside of this planner, as I'm sure by now you can tell. Anything that I can stick on this planner, I usually do, but for those rare occasions that I have papers that are not part of this planner, this folder has really come in handy. And then behind that folder, I have a little stickers section. Again, this is another add-on that I chose to include for this year's planner. Very colorful, and I just like having this here because it kind of like flags some areas that I might want to remember or make sure I look at. So questions that I have received on this planner in past years is the quality of the binder. I guess people have read somewhere that the cover or the pages rip really easily. Like I said, I use these planners every single day, and I have used these planners now. I think this is my 4th one, I believe, my third or fourth one, and I have had absolutely no problems with tearing or any breakage. Just when it comes to having the spiral bound feature, I think that they are excellent quality. I have used Erin Condren planners in the past, and I am not sure if her planners are still primarily spiral bound, but I remember I used to always have issues when it came to the covers kind of eventually tearing off of the spiral. With this planner, I can say that I have not had any of those issues. This hardcover stays nice. And then the other thing that I wanted to mention really quick is just how thick these pages were. This was another question that I received a few times within my reviews on these planners. And I can say that each page has a really nice thickness. The Staedtler pens is usually the route that I take when using my planner. I have never experienced any bleeding from page to page. I can definitely say that the quality of these planners is top notch, especially going from some other planners that I've used in the past. So I really, really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that you were able to gain some insight. I definitely suggest that you check out Purple Trail planners for yourself. Like I said, I'm pretty sure they have a planner for just about everybody and everybody's different lifestyles. I will have a direct link to their website, and just seeing for yourself all of the different options. You would be amazed by their little design center where you can add pictures, like I said, wording, change up colors. It's just a fun little tool that they have, especially if you want to be creative with your planner. And then even though this video is up in February, it's definitely never too late to start using a planner. I swear by using planners, I cannot imagine going through my day-to-day life without having a plan. And I am always suggesting to family and friends who want to kind of get their life a little bit more organized and on track to use a planner. Planners just make such a big difference when it comes to time management. And even though it is February, you can always get your planner to begin for the following month. So you can order a planner to begin in March, and it'll be good through the end of March for next year. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions about this planner, please let me know in the comment section below. If you could give this video a big thumbs up, I would really appreciate it. And if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please make sure to subscribe and join my YouTube family. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you all in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye.